Okay, so this is the opening stage of Devil May Cry, or the opening cutscene, I should say. It doesn't look too bad from here. The art design in this game isn't horrible from a technical perspective, but from an aesthetic perspective, it's kind of awful at times. Anyhow, that big building with the wings is where we are right now, and we're about to meet Mr. Mundus. Sorry for the spoilers, it's kind of obvious early on if you're a Devil May Cry fan. They tell you about halfway through the game, anyways. Here is his office. He's some kind of real estate stock mogul because this game's very topical.
No, this is not a
trying
failed
to get
threat.
On the whole 99% kind of thing because
should you fail
I guess
comply,
that's a thing to do. Anyhow,
the economy will be on your head.
There's his accomplice.
Shamed. And hate
her name is, later you'll find out, Lilith. She looks like an older woman who's had way too much plastic surgery, but that's not the true thing, as you'll find out later on. I don't want to spoil it for you, because it's kind of fucking disgusting when it happens. But, there it is. Anyhow, so, she's very excited that he did his thing.
Over a trillion. Soon I will own everything worth owning. I will control the world through debt. I have absolute power.
The world is at last your bitch, as am I. Nothing left but to grab it by the hair, bend it over, and... What's the matter?
As you might have gathered from that line, this game has some funny issues. Funny, quote-unquote, issues with women. They're always bitches, or Dante's mother is regularly referred to as a whore.
Dante.
And, yes, I know it's the bad guys doing it, but that's not an excuse.
Still out there.
The Arkham City problem all over again.
They found Sparta and his whore.
And there you go. Again.
When they do,
whore. It's just a recurring thing that happens over and over in the game. And it hits that level of, like, there's something wrong here. Pretty quickly, actually. Anyhow, so we just met the villain. So now let's meet the quote-unquote hero of the game. Dante. First we have to meet some angel strippers. Except in classic sort of bad action movie tradition, there are strippers that don't actually take their clothes off because something or other. I don't know. Anyhow, in this whole scene, well, written and directed by Ninja Theory, Alex Garland, seriously, you should probably know better than that. I mean, you're not the best guy in the world. Come on. Anyhow, this whole scene of Dante getting drunk in a strip club, apparently, / dance club, maybe, and he starts hallucinating that there are demons there. I think hallucinating, I don't know, and he's drunk. Horses. And everyone's demons around him. The watch him there, that text overlay, the environment thing, is an effect they use all the time, and it never becomes anything really interesting. Of course, Dante is amused by the strippers acting out lesbianism on stage because he's the virile heterosexual male, virility, another ongoing joke in this game that we'll get to later. And of course they go home with him, why wouldn't they? He's the hero, and they play around with his guns in an amusement park, and then go back to his trailer. Yeah, he lives in a trailer. And that gets him the girls, and they have video game sex, which means you never actually see them having sex. No one actually gets their clothes off. But there it is, anyways. Welcome to DmC